perfectly. So it is the job of the apostle to begin to lay the foundation and perfect the thing. Teacher, I need you in place. I need you in place. Pastor, you need to stay there. No, you don't need to move. You don't need to do anything that I tell you not to do. You need to stay right there because there's coming another gift that's going to undergird you called the evangelist. So it's very hard to pastor and be an evangelist at the same time. And then you have the evangelist that the apostle tells, you know what, I need you to be still. I don't need you to move much, but I need someone to help you with that prophetic gift, so I'm going to assign you to a prophet. And then you have the apostle still in line doing what? Doing what they do best, and that's lead and lay the foundation. So here you have it. An apostle lays the foundation with proper doctrine and spiritual structure. So what happens then if you take the apostle out of the picture? You have a foundation that is faulty and not built on the rock. Amen. You have faulty. You have a fourfold ministry when God said, "I gave some." And then you have the prophet who functions in revelations and points the way of believers. Come here, prophets. Come a little bit closer. This is why you are so important. You are there not to tell the apostle what to do, but you're there to point the way for believers. And if you're not pointing or if you haven't been taught, you'll think that you can tell your apostle what to do. Come on, somebody. Or you'll begin to think that you can tell the evangelist how to evangelize. And that's not what God has called you to do. Prophets are there to declare the divine will and mind of God. I ain't got nobody, but I'll go by myself. Evangelists, they outreach to grow the assembly. You see, what I don't need is I don't need an evangelist in the house of God trying to re-evangelize to the people of God. I need the evangelist out in the field working. Amen. Because if they're evangelizing to the will of God, then the pastor is not needed. And because the order is that the pastor is needed, I need you to stay in place.
Amen.
Amen. And the pastor is set in the house to cover the flock. They are bound to the assembly in a shepherding relationship. So it's very hard, not impossible, for a pastor to try to have all these other things going on and still try to love people and care for them well.
Amen.
Y'all making me work, but it's okay. Teachers. They are responsible for truth by teaching, facilitating the truth, and helping believers grow. It is not a teacher's responsibility to operate in the office of the prophet and tell the apostle what to do. When they've done that, they've now taken positions, guess what, out of hand, and they leave a ministry that is handicapped. See, one thing is, one head is a vision, two heads is a monster. So we must stay in order, and some of us have a ministry or been a part of a ministry that's a monster because it's been debilitated.